Sachin Tendulkar, the great Sachin Tendulkar, the little master, has brought this one up, that perhaps things are going to change when it comes to the treatment of the ball in cricket, Mark. Now, we're talking, and we've been talking ball tampering for a long time on this programming, but the use of saliva for shining of the ball, could it be outlawed, and may other techniques be allowed?
Oh, that's interesting.
Unbelievable.
Well, it's going to be tough, that, isn't it? It's going to be hard, as we've seen with the old technique of using the saliva and... Brill cream, spit, sweat, the whole lot have been using the ball. We've seen bits and pieces in recent times of sandpaper and other things be used on the ball. Dirt, rosin, all sorts of things have been used on the ball over time. Now we're talking about potentially bringing some of those in. I can only assume there'll be a list if they ever get to that stage of outlawing spitting on the ball, which I'm not necessarily against, but they'll have to come up with a list of what can be used by all teams.
Gah.
This is the world.
Let's try nothing. Okay, yeah. You can pick it up, you can hurl it, that's it.
And that's the simple idea. The problem is the ball will be an absolute mess after about 20 overs. So we'll have to change the ball probably every 20 or 30 overs.
You think about a little bit of spit, though, that's happening when you look at a contact sport and the amount of sweat and everything else that's close proximity. I mean, a little bit of spit on the ball will probably not... a huge thing to worry about.
No, probably not. But once again, everyone will be worried about lots of things. But people, you see people spit on their hands at times. Yeah. I don't know why they do it. But
Ricky Ponting, big spit on the
Ricky used to do that and then get down and get ready to catch. I don't know why he did it, but it became something he used to do, and he was a very good catcher. So, you know, do we outlaw that as well? I don't know.
Mark, from a cricketing perspective, I mentioned the lucrative Indian Test series here in Australia. Does that just have to go ahead no matter what from a cricketing perspective? If you can get government... tick of approval?
Oh, I think if you get government approval, and that will happen, I think, for all sports, not just cricket. I think that, and the health people have to tick the box as well. But cricket will be trying, jumping over every hoop they can possibly jump over to get the Indian summer started, because it is the big summer. We've just come off probably the less profitable summer in the cycle of Australian cricket, which was New Zealand and Pakistan last year. This Indian summer is the big one. There's a World T20 beforehand, which is supposed to start October 18. So Cricket Australia will be watching what happens with the Warriors and the NRL very closely, because if they allowed to come over here at some stage, the federal government have already said that they're prepared to look at granting international teams here for special events. So that's given Cricket Australia a lifeline for possibly October, but things have got to happen between now and then, obviously.
And I've just worked out why you became a great cricket champion and not the hula hoop champion. You jump through hoops.
Oh, sorry.
You don't jump over hoops.
Well,
you jump over hurdles.
Yeah, that's why
you got it mixed up. Tubbs is an athlete. He goes over.
First yellow card for you, Peter.
Jump over any of them.